Students, now we are going to discuss about gynecium. Gynecium is also called as pistil. A gynecium or pistil, which are having a balloon-like at basal side, which are called as ovary, and a tube or thread-like structure is called style, and the tip, a stigma or a pot-like structure is called stigma. So, a gynecium is consist of ovary, style and stigma. Gynecium or pistil is a female reproductive part of the flower. A pistil consists of an expanded basal portion is called as ovary. So this is an expanded portion at the base. This part is called ovary. An elongated section called style. It is an elongated section is called a style. And the apical structure that receives the pollen called stigma. This part is only receiving the pollen grain after maturation, during pollination. So this part is called stigma. So ovary with stipe is called as stipitate ovary. Now we shall discuss about carpel. So if we cut the ovary, we can see about carpels. They are components of the gynecium. Carpels are the components of the gynecium. That means the gynecium is consist of carpels. How androecium is made up of by stamen. How corolla is made up of by petals. How calyx is made up of by sepals. Similarly, this gynecium is made up of by carpels. The gynecium is made up of one or more carpels. Carpels may be distinct or fused or united together. Depends upon the number of carpels, these are classified into various categories. The flower will be called as unicarpellary or monocarpellary if it is having a single carpel, example Fabiesi. If it is having two carpels, it is called as bicarpellary in Rubiesi. If a flower is having three carpels, the gynecium is consists of three carpels, then this is called tricarpellary pistil. It is present in Cucurbitaceae. If you see in Lamiaceae, the gynecium is having tetracarpellary because it is having four carpels. If it is having many carpels, it is called as multicarpellary pistil. Example Lymphaeaceae, lotus winding. If carpels are free from one another, it is called as apocarpus. That means the pistil contains two or more distinct. Distinct means separate carpels. Anonism. Sitapala is a very good example. Then syncarpus. Syncarpus means if the carpels are joined together in the pistil, it is called as syncarpus. The pistil contains two or more carpels which are joined together or fused together in citrus and tomato. Now we shall see about fusion of carpels. So fusion of carpels, you can see here. So if you see, all the carpels are fused at the center of axis. It is axial placentation. Here carpels are attached at the peripheral side. It is parietal placentation. It is, these carpels are fixed at the center, centripetal. So these are fusion of carpels. It is an important systematic character. Apocarpus gynecium is generally thought to be ancestral condition of angiosperm. Now we are going to see about number of locules. If a carpel is having two locules, two chambers, then it is called bilocular. If a carpel is having three locules, three chambers, then it is called trilocular. If a carpel is consist of four locules, four chambers, it is called as tetralocular. If a carpel is having five locular, that means five locules, five chambers, it is called as pentalocular. So bilocal are present in grass and shrub. Trilocal are present in banana. Tetralocal are present in brassica. Pentalocal are present in hibiscus. So ovary, bears, ovules and a specialized tissue called placentation. A septum is a cross wall and a portion of ovary. The wall of the ovary and the septa are form a cavity called locule. Like the tetralocular and pentalocular ovaries are present according to the number of locule, either it is 4 or 5. If it is 4 locule, then it is called tetralocular. If it is having 5 locule, it is called pentalocular. If it is having 2 locule, it is bilocular. So more than one locule, it is called as plurilocular. The ovaries will be called as plurilocular. Now we are going to discuss about the extensions of condensed internodal region of the receptacle. That means whether calyx and corollas are joined together, or which is having extended, or corolla and andrisium is having being nearby or far away, and andrisium and gynesium is nearby or far away, and the base is various kinds will be. First of all, we shall see about anthocore. The internodal elongation between calyx and corolla will be long. It is called as anthocore. Triophyllacy is a very good example. See here, this is calyx, it is corolla. If it is extended in between calyx and corolla, usually the calyx and corollas are fused together. That means they are very close to each other. This is one node, this is another node. Both are joined together in almost all the flowers. But in certain flower which are having anthophore, the calyx and corolla are distinctly separated from each other with a small stalk. It is called as anthophore. Next we are going to see about androphore. See here, this calyx and corollas are very close to each other. But here, in anthophore, these are extended with stalk. But in androphore, the internodal elongation between corolla and andrisium. So this is corolla, it is andrisium. In between corolla and andrisium, there is a tube-like structure. Usually it is usually very close to each other. But here, in certain flower like Gravia, the internodal regions are elongated between this corolla and andrisium. So this is called as androphore. So the third category is called gynophore. The internodal elongation between andrisium and gynesium. So this is andrisium. Gynesium, still it is going on. So in between andrisium and gynesium, there is elongated stalk is there. That means the internodal elongation is formed between andrisium and gynesium is called gynophore, which is common in capparis. Another, gynandrophore or androgynophore. They are unified internodal elongation between corolla and andrisium and andrisium and gynesium. Example, gynandrops is gynandra. So it's a very good example for gynandrophore or androgynophore. Now we are going to say about ovary position. Depends upon the position of the ovary, these are divided into various categories like superior ovary or inferior ovary or of inferior ovary. The position or attachment of ovary relative to the other floral parts, these are classified into three different categories, namely superior, inferior and half inferior ovary. What is superior ovary? It is a ovary with sepals, petals and stamens are attached at the base of the ovary. See here, this is superior ovary, hypogynous flower. All the remaining parts, calyx, corolla, andrisium are present at the base of the ovary. So this is called a superior ovary. Then what is inferior ovary? Inferior ovaries are nothing but it is an ovary with sepals, petals and stamen attached at the apex of the ovary. Look at the picture. So this is gynecium. This is ovary. Here calyx, corolla and androecium are present on the ovary. That means above the ovary. See here. Here all the calyx, corolla, androecium are present at the base of the ovary. That means below the ovary. But here all the calyx, corolla, androecium are present above the ovary. So apex of the ovary. So this is called as inferior ovary or epigynous problem. Then off inferior. What is off inferior? It is a ovary with sepals, petals and stamens or even hypanthium attached near the middle of the ovary. See here, this is a ovary. In the middle, calyx, corolla, androecium are attached. So, if it is at the base or below the ovary, it is superior and hypogynous power. If it is attached above the ovary, it is inferior and epigynous power. If it is attached at the middle, it is called as half inferior. It is epigynous power. So on the base of the ovary position, these are classified into three. Then perianth. Perianth antrosial position on the thalamus. Each and everything we can see in detail. First of all, we can see hypogynous flower. It is superior ovary. The hypogynous is a term used for sepals, petals and stamen attached at the base of the superior ovary. It is very common in Malvasia. Then we can see about epigynous. Epigynous is a term used for sepals, petals and stamen which are attached at the tip of the inferior ovary. Cucumber, apple, astrosium will become central. Epigynous is intermediate between hypogynous and epigynous. This is a term used for sepals, the petals and stamen attached at the middle of the ovary, half inferior, Fabaceae rosaceae. Then perigynous. Perigynous is nothing but the term used for hypanthium attached at the base of the superior ovary. Then epiperigynous. The term it is used for hypanthodium attached at the apex of the inferior ovary. So it describes the placement of the perianth and the androecium relative to the ovary, to the hypanthium, if present. So hypanthium is a staminal disc, a fleshy, elevated, often nectariferous. Nectariferous means they can able to produce honey in a complex thalamus. These are called as the such a kind. Now we are going to see about placentation. It is an important phimerism. What is placentation? Already you know that. Inside the ovary, if you see, this is ovary. Inside the ovary, ovules are present. These ovules, see here, look at the picture. So this is ovary. This is a ball-like structure, a swallow-like structure. Inside the ovary, ovules are attached. The ovules are attached with the ovary with a stalk-like structure is called placenta. How these attachment, that means how this placenta is attached with the ovary, where it is attached, whether it is attached at the center, whether it is attached with the wall, whether it is attached with the cell axis and the base of it, these are divided into various categories. That we can see about placentation. So placentation is an interesting phenomenon. Various kinds of placentation is there. They are marginal placentation, superficial placentation, free central placentation, axial placentation, parietal placentation, and basal placentation. There are six different types of placentations are there. One by one we can see. First of all, we can see about marginal placentation. If you see in Fabaceae plant, like Dalicus, Pisum sativum, if you see in Dalicus means avarakai. Avarakai open mani paathirukinga, have you seen the Dalicus to open inside? Here see, this is a margin. These ovules are attached with the placenta on the margin. If the ovules are attached on the margin, it is called as marginal placentation. So it is the placenta along the margin of the, what do you call, the ovary, are called as marginal placentation. Then superficial placentation. What is superficial placentation? So this is a ovary. Inside the ovary, various ovules or locules are there. This is axis. These are septum. Septum means the middle, lot of walls are present. Yeah? Lot of walls are present. See here? This is ovary. This ovary is having axis. In the middle, lot of septum is there. Septum means middle wall. Here, these ovules are attached on the wall of the septum. So ovules arises from the surface of the septum. This is called as superficial placentation. Next one, free central placentation. See here, look at the picture. So this is ovary. In the middle there is an axis. Then this axis is not attached at the top. It is freely present. So if the ovules are attached in the free of axis, then this is called as free central, what do you call it? Free central placentation. So it is with placenta which are attached at the column in the center, which is called as free central placentation. So next one is called axial placentation. What is axial placentation? This is an ovary. Ovaries are having an axis and the septum. But these ovules are not attached to the septum. It is attached on the middle axis. If the ovules are attached on the middle axis, it is called as axial placentation. Then parietal placentation. Parietal placentation is nothing but, so this is an ovary. Here ovules are attached on the peripheral wall. So if it is attached on the peripheral wall of the ovary, then this is called as parietal placentation. Cucurbita is a very good example. Then basal placentation. So this is a ovary. Here, the stalk of the ovule is called as funicle. This is ovary. This is ovule. If the ovule is attached at the base of the ovary, it is called as basal placentation. So on the basis of the attachment of the ovule with ovary, these are classified into six different types. They are namely marginal placentation, superficial placentation, then free central placentation, axial placentation, parietal placentation, and basal placentation. That's all about gynecium.